ready. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back. It's your boy Terabyt Reacts here, back with another. I'm trying to put my phone down and can't find anywhere to put it. I'm sorry. Anyways, thank you guys so much, man. I appreciate y'all for tuning in once again. Today, Prison Break Season 2, Episode 14. We're moving quite along. I'm actually surprised that I'm actually still reacting to this today. Even though I know why I'm sitting here today, I'm still surprised that I'm still watching. But this show is so fire, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's so good, man. It's so good. Bellick is in jail. You know what I'm saying? Getting a taste of his own medicine, if you will. Now things have changed. He thought he was going to have some cushy life. That's why he requested to go back to Fox River. Oh, no. Oh, no. It ain't going to be like that. I don't know if Bellick is like out of the picture now, or they're still going to give us updates on him. It's kind of sad. You know, him now getting convicted for, and he took the deal. Like, dude, you got to fight that till the very end, man. It's like, oh, to avoid the death sentence, take the deal. But, dude, you didn't kill anybody. Like, why would you take that deal? I'm not taking that deal. You're going to have to convict me. And the thing about it is this, right? If you look at the timeline of things, it doesn't make sense. It doesn't add up. It's like, you got to understand. I was like, I made that call. Like, he probably still has the phone. It's like, dude, I made that call when I was in the hospital. And then he turned up like 10 minutes later. Like, when did I have time to kill this dude? Like, it doesn't make sense. You know what I'm saying? Like, from the call to when Gary showed up at the morgue or whatever, there is no way that I could have killed him. The timeline doesn't match up. So that's why I was like, why would you take that deal? I wouldn't take that deal. But anyways, to each his own. Let's get to the reaction. I will see you guys right after for the review.
Officer Tuggle? I'm looking for Alexander Mahone. I'm his direct supervisor.
Sorry to tell you this, sir, but your boy's been shot.
Who are you?
I used to work for the president.
Why are you helping us?
Lay down on the floor. Now. Federal agent, hand me through.
Air support is telling us that they saw your vehicle traveling alone down Route 46.
Route 46, possible exit route for the convicts. I was securing it.
No offense, sir, but we're searching every vehicle.
Well, no offense. You either let me through or you get me your supervisor.
I'm supervising this roadblock, Agent Kellerman. I'm sorry, but I need you to get out of the vehicle.
Sergeant Humphreys. Burroughs and Schofield have been on the loose for less than 10 minutes. That means that at this stage, every second is critical. So if you detain me for one moment more, I will have all of your jobs. Do you understand me?
Go ahead.
What? Just let him go.
You still haven't answered my question.
Why am I helping you? Because the enemy of my enemy is my friend.
You said something about taking down the president. I'm going to assume you have a plan.
I do?
Hey! I used to have a great date. We had to put her down. It was very peaceful.
Hey. One minute she was breathing, the next she wasn't.
Yeah, he knows his face. So I was like...
Reason why I shouldn't blow your brains out!
Because I can give you the one thing that's gonna set you free.
I know where Terence Steadman is.
Bruh, this is getting too intense. This is crazy. I don't know what Steadman is,
because I arranged this whole thing.
You arranged to set me up.
That's right.
You arranged the killing of all the people I know.
I was given orders, I executed those orders, and now I have a bullseye on my chest just like you two.
I didn't trust him.
Hey.
Looks like you're having a tough time of it.
I'm all right.
Well, I'm just curious. Why don't you hang out with the rest of the ex-guards that are locked up here? Oh, yeah. There ain't any. It's just you. I'll look out after you. Make sure nobody get up in your mix. And all you got to do is bring me your dessert after the next meal. It's real simple.
I'm just looking to do my time. I don't want any trouble.
Yeah, it's what you want, and it's what I want. Your dessert after the next child. You bring it to me. You got it?
No. Wrong guy.
Well, damn.
We're good, boss. We're good. You bring me my treats, or else this goes next level. Do you understand?
He asked you a question, boy.
Are you gonna?
I hear you.
Hey. Yeah, okay.
See how easy that was?
Don't you ever make no kissing face to him. That is sus. Real sus.
Right now, we can go away, spend some time together.
Susan, I'm not a Victrola, so please don't play me like one. There's not a white man's chance in Harlem you'd ever leave your children behind.
I'm sorry.
Don't fret now. When you came to Fox River, and you spat at me like I was some kind of rabid animal, I was happy, because such a visceral reaction could only come from a woman who still cares.
The children don't know anything. I didn't want to scare them, so I never told them about you, so please, don't.
That is so perfect. Because you see what we got here now? We got ourselves a clean slate. Right.
You should have pulled that gun out. He was far away.
It's just the conspiracy, huh?
What the hell is going on out there?
Well, it was touch and go there for a minute,
but I got everything handled.
Mahone's been shot.
Yes, I know, Bill. I was there. I saw Burroughs pull the trigger. We lost a valuable asset, but
Mahone's alive.
That's good. It looked bad, so.
Where are Burroughs and Schofield?
Burroughs and Schofield are dead, and they're in my SUV. I am heading out to bury them right now.
Don't bury them. I need visual confirmation.
I'll get you a photo.
I'll say it
one more time. Don't bury them.
You know what would be nice to hear right now, Bill?
Thank you. I'll report back when they're in the ground.
You leave that on, they'll trace it.
Yeah, Secret Service. It's untraceable, but thanks.
Yo, Trey, it's me, man.
What's up?
Yo, what's going on with Casey?
I'm at the courthouse. She's getting arraigned soon.
Okay, well, you talk to her? Is she all right?
She's in jail, so no, she's not all right. What the hell happened?
Listen, your stupid ass think I wanted it to go down this way?
Whatever.
Man, I gotta go. My lawyer's gonna be here any minute.
No.
Listen. Now, look, I want you to tell Casey to put it all on me, all right? And that she didn't know what to do, she was scared. Okay, all that.
Yeah, I already told her to do that.
Mr. Mahone.
Bill Kim. You're a lucky man.
Am I?
Kellerman finished the job you couldn't.
But he, unfortunately, is still out there. And he's a loose end. You have to finish what you were supposed to take care of.
Something funny?
Kellerman's more of a loose end than you realize. He shot me.
The guy you wanted to double cross screwed you first.
Schofield and Burroughs
are probably alive. And on the run with Kellerman. Have a good day, Kimmy.
We neutered Kellerman. He doesn't even officially exist anymore.
He knows everything.
I just spoke to Kim. He wants you to finish the job.
Yeah? Well, that's not gonna happen.
This isn't a request.
This isn't a negotiation. Kim and Kellerman can try to kill each other all day long. But I'm out.
You must have forgotten how discreet we've been with what we know.
Go tell the world about Shales. In fact, I will. I killed a predator, a man who tortured and raped women, and I buried him in my backyard. I'll do the time. I don't care anymore. I'm out. Is that clear enough for you?
One brownie. It's five of my boys. You see the position you put me in? I ain't gotta stand here with the stomachs growling while I savor this delicious treat. That makes me look like a real ass. Are you trying to make me look like an ass?
You said the deal was I was supposed to bring you one dessert.
Yeah, well, I'm fickle, bitch. Now, it's five desserts. Every meal. Now, if you can't come up with that, there are other ways to making me happy.
Well, I got some other candy on me if you want some of that.
I'll break it out, bitch. It's all good. Y'all want some candy?
Yo. Okay, Bellick. Okay, Bellick, handle your shit, bruh.
Teddy!
Uncle Teddy!
Oh! How's my girl been?
Good.
You still getting more A's than an aardvark?
Yeah, I missed you.
Oh, save me a shortcake. Yes, I painted my hair. Look at you, Zach. You are a boy no more. I'm gonna have to lend you my razor soon enough.
What are you doing here? Mom said you got a job on an oil rig? Or...
That's right out in the middle of the ocean. But those metallic beasts are dangerous. Got myself injured. Don't be frightened now, sugar. The good lawyers at Dewey, Cheatham, and Howe got me a million bones for every digit I lost.
$5 million?
Which means, with all that cash, I can do anything I want now. And all I want to do is spend all my money and all my time with you.
What's the neighborhood like?
No neighborhood. The house sits on 50 acres.
We're coming out the way we go in?
No, there's a back road we'll take.
How many guards?
Usually are they in Blackfoot?
At this point.
Really, I think it just said you. That, Blackfoot.
The second I feel this thing going bad, you get a bullet in the head.
I'd expect nothing less.
Paul Steadman.
If that's my sister, I would like to speak to her.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Right away, sir. Evac? Mr. Steadman, do you have a jacket? We need to leave.
Leave? What? No.
Agents will be arriving shortly to take you to a safe house.
What do I need to be kept safe from?
Do you have a jacket, sir?
I don't want to leave. I want to talk to my sister.
I've been authorized to use force if necessary. Now, is there anything you'd like to bring?
My meds.
Go with him. Car's here in 5 minutes.
Do they have 5 minutes?
Hello?
Things are looking up.
That's what I wanted to hear, man. Kick it down to me.
The lawyer seems like he knows what he's doing. He thinks he can get the bail reduced.
Good. All right, well, listen. When Casey gets out,
I want you to deliver this message for me, okay? Tell her that we can all get lost.
You wanted to jump bail now? Well, you better be glad you ain't in front of my face so I have my hands around your neck.
Listen, punk, just deliver the message.
Okay, then what y'all gonna do? Go live in a cave?
I got a plan, all right?
All right, well, let's hear it.
This guy back in my unit, when I was in Iraq, he used to go out to Alaska and work at these fish hatcheries, man. They pay you cash, and nobody asks questions.
Alaska?
Yeah, Alaska, man. They don't bother you up there, man.
You know, me, Casey, and Dee Dee, we could be a family again. You feel me?
Man, you don't quit.
You did straight. I don't quit.
We need to move Steadman to location beta. We're sending a car to pick him up.
It's already here, sir.
Nope.
Couldn't be. The car just left.
Weapons down! Down! Terence, step away. Get in the car.
You look pretty good for a dead man.
Get in the car!
Wait.
Who's there?
It's Kellerman.
He's got Steadman. Do not let him escape. Kill Steadman. Kill them all now.
What?
Paul, please. Don't.
Get in!
Don't kill me!
Get in the car!
Let's go.
Pam.
Alex Cameron's been hurt.
What happened?
It was a car hit and run. He's in the hospital and his leg is broken in two places.
I'll be on the next flight to Colorado, okay?
He's in surgery now.
I'll be right there. Just hold on.
They won't let me see him. They call me at work. I come right here and now they won't let me see him.
Damn, please, just keep it together until I get there. Can you do that for me, okay?
Please hurry.
Mr. Mahone, you cannot get on a plane. You need to stay at least another day for observation. You've been shot. Mr. Mahone, please.
I gotta go see my son.
Mr. Mahone, I understand. Please, at least stay and talk to a doctor.
Hey! How's your boy? Tib-fib fractures are bad, but if the growth plate's affected, there's a whole host of problems.
You made a mistake.
No, you did. Think you could just quit? Like you work at a post office? Now.
Yikes.
You need it back in. Go clean up your mess. Maybe there won't be another accident on the streets of Durango, Colorado. Understand.
You're getting all the bad guys on our side. They crazy for messing with these lunatics that y'all keep.
I don't care if it's a group announced touring Yellowstone. Their camper gets turned inside out.
Logistically speaking, every road's gonna
take Montana. Not Manhattan. Get it done.
Yes, sir.
If we get a camera, we can take a picture of him holding a current newspaper. If we put that online, well, that'll prove he's still alive.
It'll prove that we found a guy that looks kind of like the president's brother.
Fingerprints, dental records.
We whitewashed him. He pulled his teeth, burned off his fingerprints.
DNA.
To compare against the homeless guy we killed and put in Steadman's car, but we destroyed all exterior DNA samples so that there'd be nothing to compare them to.
There's gotta be someone somewhere who can identify this man.
Which is why we did the surgery. Cheekbones raised 2 centimeters, ears lowered 1/4 inch. Not so much
Jesus Christ, man.
But enough that any forensic comparison of a photograph of that man would conclude that he is a lookalike. A hoax. Trust me, we are very good at what we do.
Except killing Lincoln.
Please, just let me go.
Terence, you made every man in this room a prisoner, including yourself. It's time to set us free.
Nothing you do will work. They will not let it.
Cut the victim act, Terence. He was more than happy to play along when he was lining his pockets with taxpayer money funneled through Echofield. And then, when the indictment is about to fall,
who do you come running to for help, Terence?
And we're going to stay here for a day or two until they think we're 1,000 miles away. And then we're going to make our way to D.C.
Take him to a city crawling with company and feds.
And
Government agents still in power who have been working from the inside with your father. People who can get that pain in the ass to safely tell his story on the record.
And we just stroll right into the lion's den then, huh? Pray we don't get mauled.
I don't think they're gonna come to Montana, Schofield, so we're gonna go to them.
I don't get it. I'm confused.
You are smarter than a bee stick. Second female president of these United States, right here, watching TV with us.
Let me stretch. Right, I've been sitting here for so long.
Honey, that's all right.
No, I'll get a rag.
No, I can. I thought we had wiped the slate clean. Where it belonged.
We did put the past where it belonged.
Do not lie to me, woman. After turn cold meat of the authorities, and everything we had after breaking my heart into so many pieces that I will never get rid of. And the more you can at least do me the favor is to not stand there and lie to my face.
What?
Zach, you get your ass back on that couch!
Bitch!
Get crazy, go!
Oh my God.
I gave you all a chance. Remember that.
Dude, you're crazy.
Is that what the other cons are saying?
Yeah.
Good.
But you took it to Banks. I don't think you want to be messing with him, man.
I mess with anybody who tries to punk me out.
Hey, you know I just been testing you.
Yeah, well, the test results came back. And top bunk's mine now. You got a problem with that? What's up, Stoltz?
You screwed up, Brad, big time.
No, I had a message to send, and that message got delivered.
The guy you schlocked, Banks, he's got connections with the guards working nights. Word is, Banks is gonna have you pulled out of your cell tonight.
Well, can't you do nothing?
Yeah, I can warn you, which is what I'm doing.
Well, can't you talk to some of the guys working nights?
They're working nights because you put them on nights. Should have treated the men better when you were here. They ain't gonna do you any favors, Brad.
I treated you right, didn't I? Come on, Stolte. Get to do something. Please?
You did treat me right. But there is nothing I can do now except warn you. Watch your back.
His tone always changes when he's in trouble.
Fun for you, Terence, really?
No, this isn't fun. What was fun was when Caroline and I would talk about you and the schoolboy crush that you had on her. He proposed to her. You actually thought that you would be the first husband, the serf who would be king? Caroline! We laughed so hard.
You stood there and watched him kill Veronica!
Burroughs!
You did nothing!
Burroughs!
He died because of you!
Killing those people, ruining my life.
You'll get a handle on your brother.
You're not helping. You're not helping, Link. You don't want to do this. Trust me. This isn't what you want. You don't want to do this, okay? Trust me.
So many people dead. And he gets to live.
What?
Damn.
Didn't bother that it was all you. Case is going into the system now. Aiden and escape con. She's looking at major time, man.
I want you to tell her lawyer. All right, you listen to me. You tell her lawyer.
What?
I love you.
Just screw that woman for life.
Tell her lawyer, I'll turn myself in, okay?
No. Casey said you need to run. If you get busted or turn yourself in, Dee Dee won't have either of you. And they'll just throw in the foster care. Look, man. I'm gonna hang up this phone right now, because I feel I might say something I regret.
Yo.
You just take care of Dee Dee.
sweet.
Then get my gun from him. We don't have time for this.
You still think you're running this show, don't you?
You still think I'm not?
Yes, I'd like the number for Channel 11 News, please.
What are you doing? This is not the plan. Hang up.
Yes, connect me. I'll hold.
Schofield, you call the news. They call the cops.
Yes, put me through.
Hang up.
Hang up the phone now. Hang it up!
Channel 11 News, can I help you?
This is Michael Schofield. I'm at the Cutback Motel, room 11. And I want to turn myself in.
Yes?
Mr. Kemp, I just wanted you to know that I'm getting back to work.
Good. So I take it you got my message.
Oh, yeah.
Loud and clear.
Loud and clear.
I'm telling you. It's, I don't know. Oh, damn. Yo, he killed him. Yo.
Sorry,
TV
Terence,
dialogue.
It's too late. The press is already on their way. You can put the guns away now.
This goes wrong.
You guys are on your own.
No, if I go back home. Okay, let me please.
You can't lie. I'll go home. Terence. None of us can. Okay, so just relax. Keep your head
off. Okay.
Terence!
I'm leaving!
Just listen. Terence, for once in your life, do the right thing. All right? So many people have suffered because of this, because of you. But when the press get here, you can tell the truth. You can end this.
What is in it for me? Disgrace? Life in prison?
You're already in prison, Terence. How many more people have to die so you can stay locked up in some cabin in the woods? It's over.
It's not over, man. Nah, he's gonna dip.
Okay.
Okay.
What's gonna happen? There's still tension in the room.
Sorry.
Terence!
Safe to go.
Go where? We got Steadman.
No, we have nothing. All we got is a John Doe.
My bruh. God.
Michael, let's go.
I think I've had enough for today. I think I've had enough for today, man. On some real shit. Why is this show so good? And just when you think there's gonna be a breakthrough, and the thing about it is like this. Anticipation is just like, yeah, we're getting through to him, but there's still this tension in the room and you don't know what's going to happen. The minute he said sorry, I was like, yeah, he's gonna kill himself. So now the brother is actually dead. What's next? This show just pushes the line, pushing. You know when you're right up against something, you know what I'm saying? You right up against something and you keep hitting it and it just keeps getting further and further away. The more times you hit it little by little, that's what the show is like. You know what I'm saying? It's like there's a line that you think that they're not gonna go there, right? They're not gonna go there. Like, you keep thinking they're not gonna go there, and then they boom, hit that line, and push the line over a little bit more. It's like, all right, we've seen them do that. You know what I'm saying? They're definitely not going to do this, right? And then boom, they hit that line. It's just, it's so good. But I think I've had my fill for today. I might drop, might do some more episodes tomorrow. I have to take a break and then watch something else. But this has been an incredible, my God, this was been an incredible day for me today, just watching this series. Let's talk about the episode. So we got Kellerman on our side, and we went to get Steadman, and now we are here trying to figure out a way to get him to talk about all this stuff that happened. The problem is they can't just go to any news outlet and talk about this, or have him hold up a newspaper of something current or something like that. Like, there's so much more to it because of how they planned out the entire thing. You know what I'm saying? It's like, even if they presented him as Terence Steadman, they still could say this dude is just a lookalike. It's basically a John Doe, a living John Doe. That's pretty much what he is. So nothing would have helped. He wouldn't have been of help. I don't know what Kellerman was planning in the first place. And the situation is, put him in a desperate situation. Then he got himself a gun and he was gonna leave, and then he decided to kill himself. So now when Caroline hears about this, she's the president of the United States. How will she react to this? We haven't seen her in a while. I think maybe they don't have the actress as their at their disposal anymore. Maybe, I don't know. It's intriguing to me. They didn't give us any update on Sarah, but they were giving us update on Bellick. Bellick is not really a big deal to talk about right now. His story is his story. It's a big, you know what I'm saying? It's a part of it, but not really a part of the main connections of what's going on right now. So it seems like the tide is turning for us, the quote unquote good guys, right? It seems like the tide is turning for us to go on the offensive against these people, because now we possibly have Mahone on our side as well. And it seems like it's some of the most unlikely people coming together, because Kellerman shot Mahone. So if he does come over to our side and start fighting against the company and all this conspiracy that's going on, they're not going to like each other. If Sarah sees Kellerman, that's another problem again, because if we do get him back in contact with Sarah, Sarah is going to want to kill him. Michael is probably going to want to kill him for what he did to Sarah. It's not going to be cool. It's not everybody. The only people that's going to be cool with each other is Michael, Sarah, and Lincoln. That's it. So at this very moment, things are just awry. Like, nothing is really going right. You know, people are dying. We have Teabag over here trying to kill his family or whatever. I don't even know what can't believe Teabag has a fan base. Like, that shit is astounding. But in any case, this was brilliantly done, brilliantly executed. I have nothing bad to say about this episode, man. It was well done. And they covered a lot, gave us an update on a lot. So thank you guys so much, man. I appreciate y'all. Make sure you hit the like button on the way out. I'll see you guys for the next one, man. Peace.